The Philippines projected to remain the world's largest rice importer in 2025. The United States Department of Agriculture expects the country's total rice imports to reach 4.2 million metric tons next year. This is 100,000 metric tons higher than its estimate for 2024. The U.S. agency cites for its forecast the continued increase in rice consumption in the Philippines, driven by population and tourism. If the projection materializes, it would be the third consecutive year the world's country, or the country, would in fact import the most rice in the global market. The Philippines is the seventh largest rice producer in the world, behind Thailand and Vietnam. Now, rice imports account for about a fifth of the country's annual supply, based on government data. Subsidies to Philippine government-owned and controlled corporations were at 19.59 billion pesos in the first quarter. The Treasury Bureau says that figure is 8% lower than the 21.31 billion pesos recorded in the same period last year. The National Irrigation Administration secured the biggest subsidy at 10.3 billion pesos. It was followed by the National Food Administration with 2.3 billion and the National Electrification Administration with over 2 billion pesos. Business tycoon Manny Pangilinan's group has formalized its interest in buying the government's stake in the Subic-Clark-Tarlac Expressway. SETEX is the country's longest expressway at 53.77 kilometers. The Basis Conversion and Development Authority says the MVP group has submitted a proposal to acquire its stake in SETEX. Now, a technical working group was also identified and formed to identify the proper valuation of the acquisition price. Pangilinan, who chairs the now private Metro Pacific Investments Corporation, operates six major expressways in the Philippines. On Thursday, the Philippine Central Bank's Monetary Board meets for its third rate setting of the year. Monetary authorities are expected to keep the borrowing rates steady as concerns over inflation and the Philippine peso's weakening linger. A survey by Business World shows 17 out of 19 analysts expect the BSP to maintain its benchmark rate at a 17-year high of 6.5%. A supermarkets group vows support for food manufacturers' pledges to hold back price increases of their goods for the next 2 months. The Philippine Amalgamated Supermarkets Association says they will honor the move by not implementing price increases themselves. However, the group adds that if they do so, it would be on non-essential items. The group, however, admitted it may find it hard to keep the price of rice stable during a looming wage hike, to which it is expected to result in a 4% increase in commodity prices. The Philippines and Singapore ink a deal to upgrade air connectivity between the two countries. In a statement, the Civil Aviation Authority of Singapore said the latest deal allows the two countries to offer up to 150 weekly code share services, that is, to carry passengers between Singapore and Manila. Now, a code share is an arrangement between two airlines to share the same flight. There would also be no limit on code share services between Singapore and other points in the Philippines. It also now allows carriers from the Philippines that are owned or controlled by foreign nationals to access the traffic rights exchanged in the deal, as long as their principal place of business is in the Philippines. Previously, only airlines that were substantially owned and effectively controlled by Filipinos could do so. The latest deal is an upgrade of the 2010 bilateral air services agreement between the two countries.